Hello and welcome to Act Like You Know 12.0. My name is Kashi Johnson. I'm a theater professor and chairperson of the Department of Theater at Lehigh University. In 2007, I created Act Like You Know, the only college hip hop theater course of its kind in the country. I wanted to create a class that would unite my passion for teaching acting with my love of hip hop. You see, I grew up in Queens, New York in the early, so I get my love of hip hop honestly. Act Like You Know began as an experimental course, and over the years it has grown into a legacy. Before we get started, a few fun facts. One, all the rhymes are original. If they spit it, they wrote it. Two, everyone in this class had to audition first. And finally, the last time we were all together as a group was March 5th, 2020. Then we went on spring break and coronavirus hit. Before I could think about the implications of what this all meant, one of my ride or die Act Like You Know alums named Kevalise reached out asking what I planned to do. You see, this class is Lehigh famous for its final show showcasing hip hop theater. We didn't know if we could do hip hop theater without the theater, but we decided we were going to try. And so we continued to work in the very spirit that hip hop was created in, making something out of nothing. Together, we rose to the challenge, charted a path into the unknown, and ended up here with all of you. This film is our end result. In addition to creating, rehearsing, collaborating, and performing remotely, all of these students had to learn how to act for the camera and develop new skills as directors, cinematographers, and film editors. At every turn, they raised the bar and elevated the game. I'd like to give a special shout out to Serena, Sienna, Jay, and DT, the dedicated squad of Act Like You Know alumni who helped me in every way, from choreographing and film editing to marketing and promotion. This experience has truly been a labor of love. I'm so excited to share this final flick with all of you. Whether you are an Act Like You Know newbie or a seasoned veteran, this film will definitely be a new experience for all of us. I wanted to debut it here on this YouTube premiere so that we could all watch it together. The cast and I will be hanging out in the comment box, and we would love to hear from you.
Yeah. repeat this. Yo, a lottie dottie, we like to party. We don't cause trouble, we don't bother nobody. We're just a man that's on the mic. And when he rock up on the mic, we rock the mic. That we create, cause that's our mission. So listen to what we say, because this type of shit, it happens every day. I woke up around 10 o'clock in the morning. I gave myself a stretch up on my morning. Hey! Hey! There was a rumble jumble, 5 minutes it lasted. The mirror said,
you are, you conceited bastard.
Yeah. Yeah. But that's true, that's why we never had no beef. So then I washed up the soap and brushed my gold teeth. Oh. You wanted on the plane cause my skin gets pale. And then I got the file for my fingernails. Oh. Due to the night and on my behalf, I put the bubbles in the tub so I can have a bubble bath. Clean, dry was my body and hair. I put on my brand new Gucci underwear. Oh. Fresh dressed like a million bucks.
Hey!
And I flashed my butt. Woo! I stopped short. Oh no! I went back in. I forgot my candle. And then I dilly dally. I bumped to the alley. Bumped into my old girl
Sally
from the alley.
Woo! Yo!
Looked upset. She said, it's all because of you.
Woo!
Now my life is filled with rainy days, cause I love you so. How much you never know.
Hey.
You took your love away from me.
Caesar, uh-huh. Queen Bee, uh-huh. That's me, Yo Kim.
You all be buying in bees, so all my girls be eyeing. See, coming backstage, dying, you get pleased. You got me, I rock the Versace and linen. Well, you spot him grinning with a bunch of boxy women. Well, you speedball with God, that's invalid. I get clothes custom made from a stylist. Cruise in my Lexus land with no mileage. Well, you walk the streets until your feet get calloused. Think in a natural high like a pilot. It be all good, toss your clothes like a salad. When it's all over, put your vote in my ballot. It's my diner, I'm Mel and you're Alice. Spend a night in Little Sea's Palace. It be all good as long as you don't act childish. Well, you stand there with the crisp in your cup. If worse comes to worse, keep this on the hush.
I know you see me on the video.
True.
I know you heard me on the radio.
True.
But you still don't pay me no attention. Listening to what your girlfriend's mention. He's a slut, he's a hoe, he's a freak. Got a different girl every day of the week. It's cool, not trying to put a rush on you. I had to let you know that I got a crush on you.
Hey yo, shorty, won't you go get it back or the lethal? I'll be undressed in the bra or see through. While you count your jewels, thinking I'ma cheat you. The only one thing I wanna do is freak you. Keep your stones, I got my own baguettes. And I'll be doing things that you won't regret. Little Kim the queen bee, so you best take heed. Shall I proceed?
Yes indeed.
I'ma throw shade if I can't get paid. Blow you up to your girl like the army grenade. You can slide on my ice like the escapade. And itchy itchy yaya with the marmalade. Who me? Not you. Oh yes, who's he? I even did your man style, but I love your profile. Whisper in your ear and get you all shook up. But don't blush, just keep this on the hush.
I know you see me on the video.
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right for a slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. If you can't let this one slide.
I am in the house with nothing else to do. I wanna go outside so I can be with you. I hate it here in this house. Get me out. I hate it here in this house. Get me out. Quarantine!
Hey, Leona, what's up? How was class? How you been?
What's good, Monet? There she go, my best friend.
Yo, I'm overworked. My teacher been tripping.
Oh, really? How was that? I got time. I could listen.
Girl, they on a mission working harder than we ever did.
That's what I heard. Some professors be bugging, sis.
Yeah, all of a sudden, I got these final exams. I mean, damn.
I'm just trying to understand.
Corsite.
Gmail.
Banner.
Zoom.
All this technology got me hella confused.
Zooming in class, I be talking to my boo.
Damn, that's true, because that be me too.
True.
Relationships will not be canceled. Love will not be canceled. Songs will not be canceled. Self-care will not be canceled. And hope will not be canceled. May we lean into the good stuff that remains.
It's MC and Plastic, and we're here to say, chilling with the crew is the only way. Girl, what you got?
You know I spit these flames.
And what about you?
I ain't coming to play.
Let's show them who we are in our day to day.
Okay. It's Jazzy B in the life, present on the decks, and Zen in front of you now to spit what's next. Yeah, I rap Brooklyn, yeah, the 646, and the MTA can suck my I spent my days as an engineer in training, but my passion lies in something more amazing, like creating the blends and the flows and music, yeah, you know, that speaks to the rhythm of your soul.
Plastic imbued with the peace of God, it be your queen, and I don't lightly trod. With this crown, stand tall, chin up if I fall, living it up because I'm having a ball. Nigerian blood running through my veins, been through some shit, but don't dwell on the pain. Can't seem to shake the habit of dimming my light, but I'm ready now, turn the dial till I shine bright. On YouTube, showing off my creativity, yes, I represent. By sharing positivity, I'm built to be independent, to transcend. Learn to see the value in being a friend. I got my family and my friends riding for me, and I am who I am, just like JC, yeah. Just like JC. Just like JC. Just like JC.
When you hear my name, no, they ain't talking about the stallion. It's me, MC, here to take all the medallions. I'm a winner, never a quitter. Can't make me bitter. Wishing for me, throwing pennies, but they counterfeiter. And I'll show you just how I go through and sweep your whole crew. Say some slick shit real quick and get hit with these rhymes. I can never come whack on a track. My confidence is going up, so I suggest you stand back. Keep me in your presence. Trust me, you won't need your Prozac. Just be sure if I'ma do it, then I'm gonna attack. I eat the beat up with my cutlery, and I don't take no fuckery. So let me say in summary that up is where I'm gonna be. Ha! Up is where I'm gonna be. Let me say in summary, up is where I'm gonna be.
Damn, I gotta admit, I got a few pedas pressed, and that BX of me is telling me I gotta address. Mama's baby, she ain't playing, don't wake up that lioness. And Leona stay popping, curls really been blessed, dear mommy. You know I'ma rise above, rare sight, I really come, a dime, a does, I ride for mine, cause those are the ones that I love. Estoy con toda la mierda, I just do what I does, no need to prove my shit, you know I'm one for the books, too busy looking at me while you getting overlooked. This heat been coming, it ain't overcooked, how she still driving, I'm surviving, got these haters shook, but I'm focused. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize and I'm hungry, trying to keep that fire alive, but I'm lucky. Closing my material eyes, I'm from DR, where genius taught us to be free or to die.
Hustle and ambition run through our veins. If there ain't no pain, there ain't no gain.
It's a legend, coming straight out of Manila. 3.9 GPA, it gets no realer. Laying it down like a Casanova lover. That's why they call me the Phenobo Wonder. A rare individual, lady says get physical. I see you looking quizzical, I spare you the vision. Always on the hustle, never settle or lack. Damn right, my Harvard MBA is next on track. But if I'm being honest, all of that's just clout. Jesus Christ in my life is what I'm all about. Yeah, I've been a thief, real horny and a liar. But through it all, my boss be hot as hellfire. Christ is the key, yo, lap is the key. Ho, some are blind through the pride, that through the ego. I keep it tight, command G-O-D. So call me saints in heaven's OG.
I've always been outspoken. I want to be heard and understood. I speak truth to power. What I have to say matters, and it's all for the good. My childhood was not perfect. I could tell you all the ways that my parents and siblings failed me. I could tell you all the ways that I failed myself. And maybe I will. But for now, let's start with the good. Let's talk about how I was born into a family where the one thing my dad cares about is his children being successful. Let's talk about my mom, who basically gave up her whole life for her kids, living for us every single day, and she forgot how to live for herself. Let's talk about my three super smart siblings who are always making the family proud, who are my role models, inspiring me to live my life out loud. But most importantly, let's talk about how they all lovingly call me Meme. Yes, M-E-M-E, the backward spelling of my name. I remember when I found out that meme was a word. That was awkward. Meme, go get me water. Meme, go make food for your brother. Meme, don't talk back to me. Meme, respect your elders. Meme, shush. Meme, we're not talking to you. Meme, don't speak when I'm speaking. Meme, you're too young for this. Meme, shush. Meme, you must be adopted. Meme, you're the worst child I've ever had. Meme, shush. I've always been outspoken. I want to be heard and understood. I speak truth to power. What I have to say matters, and it's all for the good. Whenever I tell people I'm the youngest child in my family, they immediately say, oh, so you're the baby. You must be spoiled and get whatever you want. Testing off assumptions, so cavalier and nonchalant. I always wondered, do most last children actually have these luxuries? Is that type of lifestyle actually allowed? Or were these just fantasies that older children conjured up in their minds to flex and make themselves feel proud? Because when it came to my life, it was a total opposite. I felt like the maid of the house. My name must have tasted so sweet on the tips of my parents' tongues, especially my mother, who constantly reminded me what this training was about, to be a good wife in my husband's house. And then we could get into a fight each and every time I'd question, why can't it be my house? Why does it always have to be my husband's house? But that's another story you'd have to hear another time. The fight that I'll tell you about, though, is when I'd question why she doesn't treat my sister the same way. Why isn't she always in the kitchen with you? Doesn't she have to learn how to be a good wife? How do these life lessons transfer? Mom never answered. And I'm sure the imbalance must have been hard, but she never answered, always commanded with the I'm your mother, don't argue with me card. I've always been outspoken. I want to be heard and understood. I speak truth to power. What I have to say matters, and it's all for the good. So this is me saying no to being quiet and shush, saying no to being conditioned to be the quiet and submissive one. I have a voice. What I have to say matters. And just because I am young does not mean you should not listen. Don't be so dismissive. This is me saying no to not crossing over the line, saying no to not offending people every now and then. Sometimes truth hurts. And we'll all be fine. Sometimes truth hurts, but it can also make you a better friend. So I'm speaking up, speaking truth to power, sharing my story and my truth, because it will all be worthwhile in the end when I finally hear, Meme, we hear you. Thank you.
From under, I stand. I don't understand how I managed to keep the secret about my status for so long. It heavily sat on my throat, screaming to be let out. It's like whenever I spoke, there was more about me to say. So hear me when I say. I didn't choose to leave the Dominican Republic. The strong, warm feeling of my culture bringing me under its armor wings. My grandparents teaching me their humble ways, appreciating nature, taking care of the livestock. My little feet running to feed them hay. But in reality, the opportunities were scarce. But my parents have always known what is best for me, so I never questioned it. I live with it, and I am grateful deep in my heart. And yet, I swear I will never understand how society sees me as someone other than who I am. How can I be the stellar student my parents love, but then seen as not worthy to some because society sees me as a criminal? Those people that sound like a scratch disc repeating their favorite lines. They are here to take our jobs. They are the robbers, the shooters, the drug dealers, hiding behind their screens, tweeting like they are some experts on law, acting like they know, but they never been. I am a person. I'm not an alien, if you want to be politically correct. But how can a four-year-old be a criminal, I asked myself, because I still haven't gotten a clear answer, and a one-word answer I reject. I was brought to America the Great, ripped away from my own because my parents wanted a better future for their baby girl. No, it isn't my fault that I've always worked twice, three times, fuck that, four times as hard as my peers because I didn't see my dad for 13 hours every day, and my mom stood in a cold freezer packing meat, blood, sweat, and tears. Their sacrifice was my motivation. I managed going through high school, avoiding citizenship questions when it came time for my applications. See, if it wasn't for DACA, I would just be avoiding the hope of going to college along with those questions. And yet I don't understand how I don't deserve a spot in the place I am. I'm just another dreamer cultivating a new reality to manifest your destiny. I don't understand how I'm seen as un-American when this country does not have a set definition of what being an American is. I don't understand how I'm a foreigner on stolen land. Aren't I just... Never mind. The same questions I ask to end up in a cycle of empty answers, and these officials will never understand either, because the Supreme Court is between making a choice that literally determines my whole future, and I am eager to know. There is ambiguity settling on my throat. I am scared. Imagine your whole future being determined by 9 people and their vote. Here I am on the edge of a cliff, looking down, bird's eye view, location unknown, because the sentiment of not knowing where I'll be a year from now is alone. These events and decisions I have no control over, they suffocate me. Anxiety sits on my right shoulder. But I guess my secret is finally out. The broken sentences are finally complete, and they become full-on paragraphs about the lineage and the unfinished trajectory. I live and love my truth. And yes, I do get sad, I get angry, I get annoyed. Foreign in the place I call home, a prisoner to the one country that doesn't want me. Bound by state lines, repelled by various ocean tides, I dream. Because I can, because I have a right to, because I want to improve who I am. I want future generations to remember a legend. And maybe one day, we will all understand. Thank you.
Your girl Monet, my words are the remedy that brightens up your day. Try to make a pretty penny, the kind that pays. Had to recycle my watch, ain't got no time to waste. Always on my grind, so plate time is over. Never needed you for nothing. I don't feel that cold shoulder. I'm Philly born and bred. You know how I get down. We're hard to miss me. You know you see me around. I'm the really short girl with the crown full of curls. When you see my melanin, it'll give you a whirl. Black queen, you know I'm gonna rep it. So if you got a problem, then you can get the stepping. Big personality up in little old me. Why they tryna start beef? God busy keeping me. Got success in my game, and that'll never change. You heard my name, now run me my Monet.
Run me my Monet.
Do not resist the beat.
Double FMG, hell yeah, that's me. Roll up with my peeps at the place to be. Moved around a lot, but I'm back on the scene. And if you ever look for me, know I'm high in the trees. Feeling free as a breeze, and I do it with ease. Someone tell me why they really trying to check me, please. Born to be a saint, and live by the Bible, named for Mother Mary, yo. That bitch was my idol, pushed that shit away from me. When I was 16, my ass was trying to clap some cheeks and live my own dream. Now I'm like a lightsaber coming in your direction. Don't know what's up next, but I am lighting up your perception. I'm just trying to keep a vibe, there's no need for flexing. Trying to get right, what you need is the sexin'.
What you need is the sexin'.
What you need is the sexin',
yeah. I'm in war, just a kid from New York City, fighting for his dreams like the 30s Mississippi. I'm focused like a hawk, but I'm still getting litty, grinding out this work, but also grinding on them. I grew up with my mama and my grandmama, help me out. Now my grandma dead, so I gotta help my mama out, cause that's what it's about. And I'm trying to make it proud, so I'm looking forward now to my crazy future world. 6 countries, 6 months in 2020, a fellowship, scholarship, don't trip, I got plenty. In case you don't know, I'ma build a door, cause this above all is what I came here for. I've been balling since a year ago, see. Here in the States, I get medals for free. Flew to Europe and I'll bump with their knees. Play in Brazil, they samba with me. What do I want? She don't like her, so I don't know what to do. She don't like her, so
you know, we all have the same words at our disposal, a dictionary full of them, but it takes a poet to spin them into gold, as Maya Angelou did. We end tonight with some of her most famous words from the poem Caged Bird about the struggle for freedom.
And to know once again that what I feel is real. I could cry, I could smile, I might lay back for a while. Tell me what would I do if I could feel?
I only get this one chance, so I'ma spit a universe. Add a T, ask me why Lehigh, they call me G-Zone. I come from broken sticks, no stones. My mother picked them up and built a home. Family be that nucleus, everyone electrons. Reflect on, worlds collide, I press on. I break them down, build them up, new compound. Crack a joke, slave to yoke, shake them up, isotope. Fuck acting, I already know. I take matter and make it scatter. I'm serving antimatter on a platter. Pardon my vernacular, but niggas born on Saturn. I don't try to follow any of these simple patterns. Shining so bright like the world sun, I'm prone to hit you like the light from an iPhone in your icons. Spitting all this heat, call me Spyro. Trying to find the truth back in Cairo. Wrap the game up in a euro. Why the chicken cross the road, he needed more dinero. Absolute like zero.
The free bird leaps on the back of the wind.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. We all on a mission, we all got a vision.
Keep up the fight, survive the times.
Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta stay alive.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Make something out of nothing, made a dollar off a dime.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta learn to thrive.
Deep rolls, I spit flows like lyrical magma. Vibrations hit your chest plate and then give you asthma. Never been a pretender. Mexican from Denver, Tupac and Malcolm. Mixed up in the blender. Repeat offenders, they were my mentors. Avatar on the mic, lyrical bender. My flow is toxic, but it's not waste. That's what happens when you use radioactive toothpaste. Bars are nuclear and even atomic. Lyrically, the bomb is dropped. Reversing shift to tectonic. My shit is sick. I spit the bubonic plague. Lyrical sage, jump on stage and put MCs in the grave. Cause people don't know that my flow is so critical. 3.GPA with 7 grams on that digital.
A free bird beats on the back of the wind.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. We all on a mission, we all got a vision.
Keep up the fight, survive the times.
Cause
when things get the toughest, you gotta learn to thrive.
Keep up the fight, survive the times.
Keep up the fight, survive the times.
Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta stay alive.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Make something out of nothing, made a dollar off a dime.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta learn to thrive.
I was the first one here, I'll be the last to go. Living in Reading, but she from Puerto Rico. I'm the fourth of many, cause that blood run deep. I got one more year and I'm getting my degree. I'm trying to ball in life, taking mama's advice. Fuck the protocol, cause everything's got a price. See people pay with their life, chilling right on south. Looking out the window, black and mild in their mouths. Circle turned to a period because they started moving walk. Can't be running with nobody, this is trying to play the block. Went from red and black to brown and white, a night to a hop. Been working overtime because that grind never stops. I spit clean like toothpaste, it's never accidental. If I spit it off the top, it's because I'm feeling sentimental. Keeping them confused because I'm talented and gifted. Yo estoy bien dura, please don't get it twisted.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. We all on a mission, we all got a vision.
Keep up the fight, survive the times.
Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta stay alive.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Make something out of nothing, made a dollar off a dime.
Keep up the fight, survive the times. Cause when things get the toughest, you gotta learn to thrive.
And it's soon as heard on the distance, yeah. While the cage is burned, sing the freedom.
What would I do if I could reach inside of me and to know how it feels to say, I like what I see?
I'm always the comedian. I try my best to keep the ones I love happy and laughing. I talk them through their toughest times, and I smile through it all because that's the way it should be. But what about me? In our darkest nights and our brightest days, emotions fill us like tidal waves. They can drag us down and pull us in, trying to drown us from within. I've been battling severe loneliness and sadness because my relationships often feel one-sided. I put more into them than I get out, and no one seems to mind it. It feels like everyone I'm friends with is better friends with someone else. I feel like I'm alone. Even if I have people to talk to and I'm not by myself, I feel like I am alone and I am losing my grip on my mental health. No one texts me just to talk or checks up on me to see how I am, and whenever I want to talk about my feelings, they never quite understand. Instead of hearing me out, offering support and advice, they say, just be you, or go out more. So nothing changes, and I pay the price. But how can they hear these silent screams that are lurking in my mind? My friends can't feel my true thoughts if I keep telling them I'm fine. There are days, especially now in isolation, when it's hard to get out of bed. There are days when I don't eat, it's hard to sleep, and all of this just fucks with my head. It rips at my self-confidence, but still I hang on by a thread, because no matter how hard it gets, life is a poem that cannot be unread. I'm writing this poem because I have no choice. I'm writing this poem to hear my own voice. I know you can't hear my silent screams, my truth so loud it echoes in my dreams. I miss someone I could be open with, and who knew just what to say. I miss her, and how I could call her or text her, and we talk for hours about anything, even the boring things about my day. This isolation is tough to take. And though days I fight to escape in my own brain, don't get me wrong. Through hope, I remain strong. I'm getting a good degree. I have a family that loves me. Life moves on, and in the end, I'll win. So, yes, I confess. I have a lot of pain inside. Loneliness and isolation collide when no one hears my cries, maybe when my tears subside, and I can finally see. The only question left will be, do you know me?
Story. Question. Some days I'm enough, and others I just don't make the cut. Suffocating. Always measuring myself to others, suffocating, always comparing my looks, suffocating, always doubting my worth, suffocating, reminded that life comes with no instruction book. Am I enough of a friend, as some people are to me? Am I enough of a girlfriend? Am I enough of a daughter? I constantly question myself. My feelings tread water. Do I matter to anyone? Do I even matter to myself? My self-esteem comes running on short supply. Someone come stop my shelf. I never really understood my feelings. Why I was always uncomfortable with me. While the sun could be shining on others, but darkness was really all I'd see. I can't imagine myself as pretty or even see myself as unique because, quite honestly, I just don't see the good in me. It's too fucking dark. And when I try to see, clouds hover and cover me, always way too good to be true. And why do I always compare myself to you? You. She is better. They are better. Everyone is better. Constantly comparing, giving me absolutely no pleasure. You. The perfect image. The one I believe I can never be. I say I am a black queen, but when you look at me, is that really what you see? I say I am a black queen, and like classical conditioning, I say I'm a black queen, but am I really listening? Sometimes I'm not. It goes deeper than you thought, because my fight to see my light is a daily struggle that intensifies. And sometimes I win, and I hold my head real high. Sometimes my speech is loud, sometimes I act undignified. Every day I strive to be authentic, which means I tell no lies. Sometimes my actions are clear, sometimes disguised. Just know it's not those days, it's the others. When I lose my stride, when I feel fragile, uncertain, exposed, and unable to hide. Those days are hard. My self-esteem never seems to improve, giving me very little room, so darkness looms. I say I'm a black queen, like classical conditioning. I say I am a black queen, but am I really listening? Yes, absolutely yes, 1,000 times yes. I may question myself a lot, but I know I've been blessed. So I own it, I claim it, and I'm now here to proclaim it. I am a young black queen. See me for who I am. I am beautiful, I'm worthy, and I'm stronger than any man. Ask me if I can do it, and hell yes, I say I can. Because I believe in myself, and I'm my biggest fan.
Always yelling at my mama because I hate myself. I'm the splitting image of my father and I know it well. I cry myself at night because I can't even make her proud. And all my dreams and aspirations, they gonna snuff it out. And I can't hear myself. These walls be too loud. I grab the remote control and try to bring the volume down. The TV watching me, but I can't even see myself. Another number in the system, niggas know, but they won't miss them. Try to fly, but they won't let me. Got a knot up in my stomach. Never hunger in my belly. Depression never hit me. Correction, depression never hit me at my lowest point. It hit me at my highest and she strained out to my joints. My legs turn to anchors and my blood turns to sand. My tears turn to blood and I can't stop shaking my hands. Man, I just feel so blue. Now I feel great. A lack of feeling, hollowness, a feeling so vague. I don't even pray no more because God be too silent. And people can't keep quiet. Look at the violence, look at the deaths, civil unrest. Pain in my chest, pain in my heart, we growing apart. We damn from the start, we damn from the start. We damn from the start. I look to the future, looking for presence, but we stuck in the past so there is no present. Man, I feel like a peasant, only subpar. Trying to reach a bar that's set for me to go hard, my hands can't reach him. I got too much weight, maybe it's fate. Gossiping grapes, talking shit about me that don't even equate. But my life could be worse. I could be with the other father's children who won't be able to work. Yet I sit here still pouring milk out for their serial numbers and still saying that they're great. Because no matter how much we deny it, we are products of our environment. And some have the help to overcome, while others never even see a helping hand. Flesh recognize flesh. We all bleeding at some point. And my heart got holes, but I only got love for this world. If there is a fog touching, and that fog is heavy, the weight of life, the weight of what isn't even, the weight of uncertainty, the weight of what is yet to come. We need a silver lining, a light at the end of the tunnel, a funnel for good, because I can't perceive feeling this way. I can't take it. Change will come, but we must make it. Search your pockets, take your bills and break it. Amongst yourselves, spread the wealth and rejoice. For true power is that in which is heard through voice. On God.
Sometimes I have my good days, and those days I'm in luck, because most days I have no idea what the fuck is happening. Music's the only thing that's made sense to me. It's made life less intense. It's connected me to people, made unpaid levels equal. Near and far, always the same, like a sequel. Music's brought me peace, an outlet, an escape from this confusing, tiring world when I'm always trying to relate. Seriously, my days become really draining, like when I'm trying to make people feel at ease by trying to find a proper facial expressions or head movements to show that I'm listening and to do as they please. Flashing a smile, I chuckle here and there, swinging my arms as I walk just so I don't look insane, but still I'm constantly asked, are you okay? I'm fine, really. Well, you look angry. Are you tired? You look really, really sad. No, that's just my face. Keep pressing, then I'll get mad. Over time, I discovered the motto, to be seen and not heard is the motto to live by, to feel more alive at the end of the day. So I'd adopted phrases here and there to get me by and to shift the focus off of me. So if you don't remember me, then it's cool. You and me weren't meant to be. Comedy shows, horror movies, events that require instant reaction that I avoid like the plague. Nothing worse than making eye contact with someone and watching their expression go from joy to uncertainty to unsettled. Like my B, I didn't mean to ruin a good time, I'll see myself out. Of course, life gets difficult and frustrating at times, and I contemplate not being here at all. I mean, what's the point? I'll be a distant memory and people will move on eventually. And these thoughts will be on an endless loop until I put on my headphones, Bluetooth connected. Music starts, the world fades, life becomes manageable, and I'm able to tackle another day. When I first mixed in front of people, I was just high-key jamming, trying not to focus on life, and playing music that I felt would sound good together. Afterwards, when people came up to me, it hit me that connected to the people in the crowd, that we were vibing in unison to one thing, music, because music is universal and it connects us to one another. So being a DJ isn't about the money, don't get me wrong, it's a huge bonus. It's about connecting to people, discovering new music, meeting other DJs, and ultimately just trying to get by. It's wild when I introduce myself and people know who I am. It's the opposite of what I go for. But so far, it's been dope, even if unplanned and surreal. I had the cops call on me, and one of them recognized me from doing campus events. You did the tailgate, right? I'm like, damn, all right, I must be doing something right if people remember me from outside events. Because as DJ Zen, I flipped the model. To be seen and not heard no longer flies. It's to be heard and seen, to make my presence known. Because I found my voice, and it's through the sound of music. Thank you. Carolina, mama. Carolina, mama, yeah. Mama, gala, gala, go and do my video. Baby, bana, they say you like you all. I got you all, baby. What's my thing, though? What's my thing, though? 17, 18, 19, bagada. What's my thing, though? Yeah, 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 uh-huh. Yeah, 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 yeah. Joanna, Joanna, why you do me like Joanna? Sensima, why you for Sensima? This is the G-Zone, that's a real sound bag. Your week trial begins now. It's $3.99 as of now, but after the week, $100. All right, let's start it up. A hip. Yeah. Hace frío.
Yeah, keep it coming. Crew go hard, you think we spitting out a diamond? Rap rock stars, we taking trips out to the islands. You trying to come too? Nah, bitch, you not invited. Life's hard, that's a typical Wednesday. We grinding here from nothing, man, fuck what your friends say. Can't they do something a little more in their element? Spitting next to me, you'll make a player irrelevant. Hey, where you going? Act like you know is on and they be flowing. The group spit a beat and they ain't in the same room. This kind of music makes you
boom, boom.
It comes easy to a mind like me. Any doubt, yo, I'll make you believe.
Yeah.
12-0 showing up on the scene. Wanna see?
I don't. I was a kid, and I thought my dad's path was the best way to live. And I saw it on TV, how happy those American kids were across that sea. It was like the LSD of fantasies, gumdrops of escapist ecstasy, so I can run away from my third world Philippine reality. Oh, I want to sniff the idea of immigration, just like sixth grade the sniffing solvent glue, because it made me see red, white, and blue, when all around me was just family dysfunctionality that ensued. So no wonder, immigration became my favorite painkiller, as an anxiety-ridden teenager, barely surviving poverty's winter. And no wonder, the American dream propaganda became my synthetic marijuana that lit my teen spirit just like Nirvana. And no wonder, I want to seek American asylum just like I want to take Adderall. So all my sacrifice as a first generation, low income, Southeast Asian, working class immigrant, scholar would have meaning after all. But I got addicted. I got in too deep. Move into America by my lonesome. Apply to some scholarships and I won some. Now I'm in Lehigh University, study economics, theater, and global studies. But what I'm really majoring in is anxiety. I left the girl I love. I sold everything I own. I packed my bags and put on my back alone. Left mom, Mika, Auntie Vel, and Lola. Left the friends I knew to be my brothers. And for what? To be addicted in my own imagination? To be high on individualistic infatuation? To be hooked on my capitalistic delusion? Just craving for a 4.0 GPA? Absolution? Sometimes I'm not even sure whether I'm in a crack house, in a college, or in a mental institution. But I'm forever looking at the mirror and seeing my emotionally absent, alcoholic, working class immigrant dad's reflection. Addicted in finessing my green card documentation. Addicted in getting a job even before graduation. Addicted in working overtime even during COVID-19's isolation. Yo, I'm just trying to be Christ-centered man in this pandemonium. So why am I still addicted seeking my dead dad's validation? Now I'm on my knees, clenching American soil. And when the bullshit buzz and hypocritical high dies down, the colonial withdrawal kicks in. And you realize they treat colored kids like you just like a puff of weed. That's when you realize and discover that immigration is just like love, the strongest drug of all. Makes you do crazy things, like sacrifice so much that you bleed your family's tears, grind so hard you set the generational gears of upward social mobility in motion. I tell you, it makes you a junkie for justice, to serve those who have gone before you and those following your trail. Because immigration is just like a drug addiction. Makes you addicted and sniffing every rose with all humility, blowing a kiss to everyone you love, drinking the elixir of joy and family, injecting your day with the gospel from above. It makes you truly feel every blunt, shot, jewel, and pill of this blessed drug called life, because you know that's God's fucking will.
To be a Latina woman on a college campus is to face violence on the day to day. It is walking into class on the first day, praying another student of color walks in. Weeks later, it is seeing my culture reflected as costume, identity shredded into piñata scraps and slurs. It's being called mommy, walking down East 5th by white men that sexualize Latina bodies and then dismiss them as beasts. It is white women claiming no difference in our struggle, like Starbucks stereotype could ever compare to the jokes about green cards about the backs my family broke to get here. It is some women of color deeming the skin too light to be oppressed. As if oppression Olympics is a game that I could never have a say in. To be a Latina woman on a college campus is coming from a culture that never prepared me to do this on my own. It's having been taught to hide away, to sink myself into shadows so the men could have their way. It's being afraid of speaking up. Like when I try to tell my family about my anxiety and they say, Francis, quit making that shit up. We got bigger things to deal with. It's fearing that my voice will sound only like trouble, that everything I list as struggle will be taken and turned and used against me. Like any step out of line gives anybody the right to talk shit about immigration. Like I just shouldn't be here in the first place. It's hashtag tequila, hashtag despacito, hashtag whitewashed, hashtag too light skinned to be considered a person of color, hashtag Donald Trump really isn't that bad. I am tired of all of this violence, all this black and white dichotomy. Latino violence always gets ignored. Pero no, no nos vamos a callar. To be a Latina woman on a college campus is to have to scream into spaces that don't welcome me. It is always having something to scream about. It is going home every day and writing these poems, hoping that somebody out there will finally hear me.
I was born into a cycle, trapped in a loop. Destined to die dead or in jail with the rest of my ethnic group. She says she admired my strength, but doesn't know where it comes from or how far I had to travel. From the fields picking crops to the bottom of a gavel. My ancestors sweat, bled, and died. They fell just to watch me rise. And I realize as I get a little older that my feet stay firmly planted on so many shoulders. My people did the best that they could do, try to put food on the table and try to bless the youth. Nevertheless, generations of genocide and stress put us on the sidelines as we watch them play chess. Shit, matter of fact, we built the fucking board and they forced us to move the pieces. Now all we got left is hopes and dreams praying to a white Jesus. Cause I was born into a cycle, trapped in a loop, taught to rob and steal from the rest of the chickens in the coop. The same damn letters on the same damn page, everyday gambling. Rolling the dice, trying not to be another bird locked in a goddamn cage. Pops tell me, son, don't worry, I got the same judge when I was the same age. My soul filled with rage, because I was born into a cycle, trapped in a loop. Cocaine, heroin, alcoholic youth, lost in lies and hidden from the truth. Because my grandfathers, uncles, and every male role model turned into Aristotle. Looking for philosophy and wisdom at the bottom of a bottle. I'm looking for my uncle, he's lost in a loop. Sticky black heroin filled his veins and made his eyes droop. And now his nephew spaced out like him on a concrete stoop. Don't worry, son, the same cop who pressed you today slammed me on the hood of a car when I was your age. His hair was blonde then, today is gray. Because I was born into a cycle, trapped in a loop. Misogyny, trauma, victims of abuse. Watching bullets fly right by my head, just like the stories of my uncles and the ones told by my dad. Cause my grandma got hit and my mama did too. Little boys get taught to smack a woman's mouth whenever they want to. Cause I was born into a cycle, trapped in a loop. Her head on my shoulder, she got raped as a youth. Memories haunting me, jumping up on my sleep. She say, bae, it's okay, and put me straight back to sleep. But fuck that cycle, I broke that chain. No more trauma, no more misery, no more pain. I rose up out of the flame. My family has no more shame. Because I proclaim my disdain for any pain up in my window frame. I broke that cycle. I made my own loop. One with positivity and love that my lineage can put to use. Thank you.
Now tuned into the month greatest.
DJ Zen.
Me, myself, and I. Be myself and 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 I.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, tell me, mirror, what is wrong? Can it be my De La Cruz or is it just my De La Soul? What I do ain't make believe. All I do is sit in trouble. When it comes to being De La, it's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I.
It's just me, myself, and I. Now you tease my plug one style and my plug one spectacles. You say plugs one and two are hippies. No, we're not, that's pure plug one. Always pushing that we formed an image. There's no need to lie. When it comes to being plug one, it's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I. It's just me, myself, and I.
Oh, yeah!
Pulling out the coupe at the lot, turn the fuck 12, fuck SWAT, buzzing all the bells out the box. I just hit a link with the box, had to put the stick in the box. Pour up the whole damn field, I'ma get laid.
I don't hate dancing, cricket is my game. I'm the shot clock, way above the game. To be point blank with you, I'm the Hall of Fame. Tanzo from Tanzania, I ain't come for play. Listen up, my head high like Kilimanjaro. On time more than a Rolio or Seiko. My style so fresh, yours is a day old. Get up or get out, get down or lay low. 12.0, we can holler or whisper. This clan is my fam and I'm right here with ya. I'm the slim kid Tenzo, I cast a big shadow. I speak six languages, yes, I got the ammo. Industrial, systems, engineer. A scholarship recipient for all 4 years. About to graduate, but please be clear. Gonna live my life with no fear, yeah.
Day and I spit it like a laser. Quick witted, fit the beat just like a tailor. I stick with it, I'll be making all the paper. Don't like me, why you got me on replay? Nah, you spitting bricks. When I spit the whole damn wall. Drop a beat and some bars, baby, that's not all. I'm writing code, it's impeccable. Writing music, delectable. Mess around, plan my life, see the future. No spectacles, I'm a young CS from the 610. Sing too much as a hobby, just thought I'd let y'all know. You trying to hear me come through? Yeah, put on a show. Bring the homies around so you can act like you know. Yeah, keep my Latin blood hot. Fuck the struggle, I'll be giving what I got. You think you know me now? You just know the top. Time's up, so I gotta let it ride. Come on.
I was born to the southeast state of Peninsula. 5 years later that I moved to Nigeria. Had this feeling of angst and hysteria because I started living in a whole new area. Adversity, asperity, relentlessly I face. And I standing stronger day by day cause God keep giving grace. Shout out to my parents for seeing potential, man. I know it's cause of them, I'ma be monumental. Accolade to accolade, on top of that I was getting paid for studying every day and keeping the high GPA. No for sure getting my degree for computer engineering. Just got my offer from B. Lockheed Martin. When I graduate, I plan to help the people. Be a good role model, or better yet a hero. And that's how I know that we're really here to slay. Where I come from, that makes me a DK.
What we want, we can have it. I taste success, it's just a passage. And taking L's, we come back from it. Yami, J, and DK, we the baddest. Yeah, uh-huh, okay, we can transform, yeah.
Okay, we can transform, yeah, a whole new reality 2.0 got for ya.
Got me, Jay says, stay in your lane. Don't come up to my face, know your place in the race. For that feminine or from DR, I was raised, nor Philly, I was braced up on my dreams. I gazed as I pick up this pen, reported in my style. I would study all the lust to put the asses on trial. If you don't fuck with me, vete pa'l carajo. When you see me on TV, you looking up, this de abajo. Lehigh is complex, kinda hard to be the best. I haven't failed, no course, I am humble, I stay blessed. From deep in the margins, I rise to take your chest. They wanna see me poor, no generational success.
What we want, we can have it. Attain success, it's just a passage. And taking L's, become a promise. Yami, J, and DK, we the baddest.
I heard that women look for men like their fathers. If that's true, then I should do the opposite of what my gut tells me. I never had a relationship to look up to, so I had to look out to other sources. Curled up on the bottom bunk bed of my one-bedroom apartment, I got inspiration from reading Twilight and watching The Princess and the Frog. And if you know Twilight, you know it's not the best source for relationship advice. Life is not a Disney movie, and maybe Prince Naveen had some qualities Tiana should have looked into a little bit further. But they were happy. So I collected my nuggets of knowledge compiled from novels and rom-coms and fairy tales and created unrealistic expectations. Expectations that might have seemed more realistic if I had had someone to guide me. Instead, I'm out with the wolves, wondering if the text he didn't answer, the red flag I'm ignoring, and the one I'm pushing away for him is all okay because I'm happy. How do I know a man is loving me right if it's never happened before? I am a young woman lost, and I could have used your help. So now I am speaking directly to you. Where were you? Where were you when all I wanted was to curl up on my father's lap and be told that I was loved? Where were you when I had to move 4 times in 2 weeks and only wanted stability? Where were you when we were supposed to go back to school shopping for my first day of 5th grade and I waited all day for you to show up? Where were you when I cried on my mother's lap afterwards and asked her what was wrong with me? I didn't need you to be Superman. I needed you to try so that I could trust that compromises I make with my partner are because I care about the relationship and not because I'm scared he'll walk away. And so that I could know that when a man treats me like a choice and not an option, that is exactly the way it should be. I have had so much resentment for so long, it felt like a snake was wrapping itself around my lungs every time I thought about you. But I am shedding that feeling and replacing it with the knowledge that no matter what mistakes you made, I am not one of them. I am reclaiming my power and saying that you take no ownership over any of my accomplishments. The strides I make are in spite of you, not because. And the positive things you've brought into my life come in the form of making me wiser to the world and people like you. Lastly, your request to attend my graduation has been denied. Being a parent does not happen sometimes, and unfortunately, you have not met the minimum requirement needed to participate. I truly wish you the best in all your endeavors. Thank you. Thank you.
Tanzania, Africa. At age 11, I was the youngest cricket player to join the local league. At age 15, in the East African Cricket Tournament, I steered Tanzania to their first victory against Kenya and was awarded Team MVP. At age 16, I was one of the youngest cricket players to join the senior national cricket team of Tanzania. You see, growing up, I was excited about my life. I had dreams of playing professional cricket, and I could not wait. I had dreams of playing alongside the greats and seeing myself on TV with my teammates. I was only a kid. Life was simple. Dreams felt real. Who am I? I am that kid who failed to pursue his dream of playing professional sport because that was something his family just couldn't afford. And so I let go of what I adored and accepted Lehigh's great financial award. Who am I? At this point, I am so tired of pondering upon this question. I am so tired of explaining my sports background like an academic lesson. I am so tired of using words to explain what cricket is, unable to show it with my actions. Cricket is the world's second most popular sport, and yet in this country, this sport is sold so short. How can I show my talent with no visual support? I am tired of saying who I am and not being able to live it. I love school and these opportunities, but if I could, I would gladly pivot. Outside, I wear a smile, but inside, I long to play the game. But with no coach to guide me, no teammates to hide me, and no family to walk beside me, it stays a dream, and things are the same. I try to cover up these deep wounds, mask them, by focusing on being grateful for what I have. But when I stop and listen to my heart, no matter how hard I try, the memories and dreams of playing professional cricket just will not say goodbye. Who am I? These days, my constant ache for the game seems bearable. The question doesn't seem all that terrible. I wonder, could my dream of playing professional cricket, a vision so strong, be replaced by my Lehigh accomplishments? A list that is so long. I can't answer in truth. I can't even find the time to sit and ponder upon it until spring 2020, senior year, coronavirus hits. Who am I? I am the hustler that will not stop until I pursued my passion to the end of the line. I am the fighter that will stomp out negativity every single time. I am the ball of energy that will not rest until my lungs burst out of my chest, until my body has given its very best, until my mind passes this test, until my heart has left nothing to digest, until I've reached the end of this quest. Who am I? Tenzo from Tanzania, and graduation is next.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. Seen her watch, now she wanna give crutch. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life, sugar gal, let my forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that ting. Any girl you want, they were my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough. Flood my eyes, make a whole blush. Back of the tour bus, getting cool up. D square, got them de-stressed. Got a hand wash, new racks with the old Nikes in the shoebox. Keep my stripes, no cuss. Pull up in a new plate, then she might just. She went trying to move bait when her eyes locked. New tints on her coupe, that's a head loss. Off my whites, right my rungs. Gucci my mum, why you diddle your thumbs? Count my sums, this is gonna get long. Love my green, I'm trying to get strong. Trying to get on, where I'm from, it's on. Yes, man don't take no dumb threats. They see funds, they hop fence. We been up, not up, next. Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, right wrong, fizzy pop.
So you bad, come. I'm a savage, yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet, yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty, hey. Yeah. Hacking, stupid, what's happening? What was happening? I'm a savage, yeah.
Carol Baskin killed her husband, whacked him. Can't convince me that it didn't happen. Fed him to tigers, they snacking. What's happening? Carol Baskin.
Okay, I'm bored in the house and I'm in the house bored. Bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a motherfucker in a house bored. And I'm bored in a motherfucker in a house bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house bored. I'm bored in a motherfucker.
Who taught you how to drive stick? You a fool with it, love the way you fool with it. And the way you motion, motion in my lap, love the way you move with it.
Da-doo-doo, doo-doo, ooh, da-doo-doo, doo-doo, ooh, da-doo-doo, doo-doo, ooh, da-doo-doo, the very first time. No, I'm just like, I gotta do this shit. This shit is killing me. All right, deadass. No, serious, too.
COVID-19 mental health reminders.
The coronavirus is a respiratory disease that has been rapidly spreading worldwide. At the time of this recording, it has infected almost 2,629,609 people and has taken the lives of almost 183,711 worldwide.
Symptoms include cough, difficulty breathing, fatigue, fever, and can last for 1 to 14 days.
Let us help you get through this quarantine with a few mental health reminders.
Number one, get dressed. Even if it's just into comfortable clothes, this will help you feel more productive and less in a rut.
Number two, eat healthy new recipes. If you can, eat a variety of foods and try different recipes. This will give you a daily variety and keep your body feeling healthy.
Number three, be creative. Try doing new activities or bring back old ones. Getting creative is a great way to keep your spirits up and your mind relaxed.
Number four, stay connected. Even though we can't go visiting, make sure you stay connected. Video chat or a good old-fashioned phone call are great ways to stay connected. This will help you and the people you talk to feel less isolated.
Number five, style and groom. Even if you're not going anywhere, keeping up appearances can help you feel normal in a very chaotic time. People also feel more relaxed when they style and groom themselves, and you deserve that.
Number six, get some fresh air. Fresh air will help you feel less cooped up and stuck. Getting outside will be best, but even standing in front of a window can be beneficial.
Number seven, unplug. Everyone everywhere is talking about the virus. Turn off your devices and take some well-deserved time away. Wait, not right now, after you finish watching this film.
Number eight, reach out. Mental health is always important, but it is especially important during times like this. Reach out if you need to. Remember to check in with your friends and family.
We're all in this together.
Miss Corona, you were seriously a bitch. If you were a human, I would've dragged you out the ditch. Got me disinfecting everything that I own. Got me quarantined, all depressed and alone. People panicking, an apocalyptic frenzy. Flights are hella cheap, try to land here with no entry. COVID-19, should've stayed in 19. The year of 2020 already taking Kobe the legend. I'm tired of looking at the news. No more hashtag RIP, I refuse, hit the snooze.
When you're up against a trouble, meet it squarely face to face. Lift your chin and set your shoulders, plant your feet and take a brace. When it's vain to try to dodge it, do the best that you can do. You may fail, but you may conquer. See it through. Black may be the clouds about you, and your future may seem grim. But don't let your nerve desert you. Keep yourself in fighting trim. If the worst is bound to happen, spite of all that you can do, running from it will not save you. See it through. Even hope may seem but futile when with troubles you're beset. But remember, you are facing just what other men have met. You may fail but fall still fighting. Don't give up whatever you do. Eyes front, head high, to the finish, see it through.
Yeah, y'all wasn't taking me seriously before. But now, y'all gonna learn today. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Now y'all sick with it. Now y'all sick with it. Man, I'm just everywhere. Nigga, I'm ubiquitous. Now, I'm just infamous. Merge with the body, that synthesis. Mask off, now put that mask on. Dragon breath, I spit 6 feet. I take you out like I'm 60. Fuck a vaccine, daily routine. Up in the crib, wasn't too clean. 2 to 14, that's a quarantine. Now you sick, looking all green. Cut the air like a Dyson. Whew, knock your wind like a bison.
Corona. Damn, bruh, why you start this crisis? Why you do me like this? I'ma try to fight this. Don't know if I'll survive this. Stuck in the crib with nothing to do. Me and the crew feeling our blue. I gotta keep my social distance. On Zoom sleeping through statistics. Mute my mic and hide my video. Still in my PJs, eating my Cheerios. Only a shirt on in front of the camera. End of the year and I'm losing my stamina. Bored all day, addicted to TikTok, taking nugs out of the Ziploc. Zoom University said it was tip-top, going through the motions, yeah. Losing all my focus, yeah. Fuck Corona, yeah.
Yo, fuck that bitch.
Hey yo bro, why you mad?
Cause you took away my class.
Say yo bro, why you mad?
Cause you killed like poison gas.
Say yo bro, why you mad?
Bro, you wrong, the virus.
I'm just trying to fix the climate, man. I'm not a tyrant. You talking all this shit, but now you spend time with your kids. I'm the solution to pollution. New Year's resolution, cruising. I'm just helping evolution, man. Man, I'm just helping evolution, man.
Damn bro, you a hater. I can't find me any razors. No chicken in the store, and they got no toilet paper. Biological invader.
Damn, man, this shit sucks. Why that shit sucks, bro?
Cause she ghosted me in quarantine and I ain't get no text back. Left me on red and I guess I gotta step back. She ghosted me in quarantine and I ain't get no text back. Left me on red and I guess I gotta step back. Damn, you for real, bro? I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, bro, I don't wanna talk about it. Fuck it.
Corona with love. A month ago, I wouldn't stop for anything, not even for death. Now, I'm 6 feet away from everyone and everything, my dreams deferred, and I feel like there's nothing left. I'm not on vacation. I have no income. Frustrated at not finding what I need in the stores, constantly worried about the employment and the fate of those that I love, you see. I am sick, but not with Corona. Sadness is the real virus I'm facing, one that doesn't need air to propagate contagion. You can't place sadness in quarantine to contain its vicious spread because sadness feeds on itself. I just need to get out of my head, but I'm stuck between these four walls. Social distancing has turned into isolation, but I refuse to be trapped inside the confines of my mind, so I express my greatest thoughts and expectations because isolation is sad. Isolation is small. But I won't let that rule my life because that's not me at all. Some things I do know. This is our generation's greatest test. Where there is isolation, there does not have to be loneliness. Where there is fear, there does not have to be hate. We must remain focused on hope so fear can't retaliate because we can't just let our lives slip away. We have to stand up and face this new day. The pain and disappointment will subside. There will always be obstacles, grief, and strife, but you have to believe that you're strong enough to fight. Believe in yourself just enough to do what's right and hold on to everything that's at stake. For when misfortune arises, you may bend but do not break, because we have all the power we need to bring hope back into our lives. We have the power to be so much more than we realize. We have the power to win this battle and fix what's been torn apart.
Now I know you can't reach out with your hands, so reach out with your heart. Thank you.
Rushing to replenish crucial medical supplies after recording another daily high in coronavirus deaths. More than 880 people have died in the past 24 hours, taking the toll past 5,000. The youngest victim is a six-week-old baby. With more than 200,000 cases, the U.S. is by far the worst-hit country in the world.
You know about this quarantine, yeah. Everybody's stuck on waiting for this vaccine, yeah. We don't know how this gon' turn out, cause everybody's showing up with all of their doubts, yeah. You know about this quarantine, yeah. Everybody's stuck on waiting for this vaccine, yeah. We don't know how this gon' turn out, cause everybody's showing up with all of their doubts, yeah. Make those habits now and then go make a routine. Go to sleep at 6 a.m. and then go wake up at 3. I've been worried for my fans, especially the ones in Japan. When I come home, I'm reminded that everybody died, can't rewind it back. This state is so sad and so lonely, feel like nothing we can do. Cause I've been feeling a little sad and down, damn it's harder when we got nobody around. As the hardship shines, just hit us when we come to. But let's look into open light, when we turn to stick together, put a fight. Cause together we can fight all the hardships we go through. Time to fight back with all our might. Stay home and flatten the curve. Open some books and get ready to learn. Build our character up and chase a yearn. Release new content now and chin a labyrinth. Raise our voices now so we could be heard. Take on obstacles, even absurd. Cause we could stay at home and work on all those things while saving lives. Imagine all the joy that it brings to all the healthcare workers risking their lives and all the families that say. Cause I've been feeling a little sad and down. Think it's harder when we got nobody around. And as hardship challenges hit us, what we gon' do? But let's look into open light. When we're done, stick together, put a fight. Cause together we can fight all the hardships we gon' do.
Welcome to the Sunny Day News Report. I'm your host, Megan Carroll. Today, we're still under strange circumstances and it may feel anything but sunny. We're still stuck in our homes, we miss our friends, and we're counting down the moments till we can order bottomless mimosas at our favorite restaurant. This time is tough for everyone, but as AB Link said, this too shall pass. Luckily for you all, I have exclusive footage from the future. Yes! You heard me correctly. The future. Here's the footage. Today marks the full official opening of the world. The COVID-19 vaccine has been delivered to all homes and there are as little as 50 cases across the country. People are leaving their homes in unprecedented numbers. Inspired by the environmental benefits of quarantine, people are choosing to walk and ride bikes to enjoy the day rather than drive. Salons of all kinds are open and safe to visit, thank goodness. Gyms remain abandoned, but this time by choice. Folks are visiting loved ones and taking no moment together for granted. President Trump has decided to take the advice of professionals and only say things that are factual. This is truly an incredible time in our history. Now, I know this feels unrealistic and far away, but sometime soon we will return to normalcy. It's hard not to know when that is. But in the meantime, we can do what we can to bring some sunshine to our lives. Read a new book, binge watch a show, get a new hobby, cook a new recipe, or Zoom chat with some amazing friends. This has been the Sunny Day News Report. Thank you for watching.
When this is over, may we never again take for granted a handshake,
a stranger.
Full shelves at the store.
Friday night out.
The taste of communion.
A routine checkup.
The school rush each morning.
Coffee with a friend.
The stadium roaring.
Life itself.
When this ends, may we find that we have become more like the people we wanted to be.
We were called to be.
We hope to be.
And may we stay that way.
Better for each other.
Because of the worst.
What did Kashi teach me? Where do I begin?
Come in, and then she asked me to perform for her, and she gave me 3 pieces of advice. The first was stop chewing gum. It's disrespectful. I was like, oh, dang. The second was die with your secrets. Be confident. Don't tell the other person what you're messing up or how you're messing up. And the last thing was, to project my voice. I could be wrong, but yeah, I think the last thing was just to project my voice and be a more confident performer.
So Kashi really taught me that it's okay to go with the flow of things and just see how things turn out, because at the end of the day, if you're not trying to strive for it to be perfect all the time, it could be something really great. So yeah.
And with Kashi, you need to be in the moment and you need to get out of your head, and she tells you that from day one. And
that first show that I watched meant everything to me. Like, I felt so comfortable and I felt so like inspired by not only seeing the students on stage, but seeing the audience interaction, like how everyone goes crazy when like their friends come out.
I think that this class and her have been so important to me, to like expressing who I am in my art, in my form. So yeah.
I will have to say the things that, you know, I've learned from Kashi Johnson and the entire Act Like, you know, 12.0 family, together with Serena and Sienna and everyone who, you know, like Julius and DT who's joined in, is this sense that hip hop at its core is about community, right? And it's about telling truth about the community, telling, you know, stories that can be related to your upbringing, your identity, about your truth, right? And that it grows bigger as you share it with more people. And
hip hop is the voice of people. It's used for us to express ourselves, whether it's through dancing or through speaking our truths through our rhymes. Thank you.
When it really comes down to it, we need hip hop to survive. Hip hop has always been a mechanism for our people to survive. It's always been an apparatus to help us get through the hard times. Hip hop is used to heal. Hip hop is used to hurt. Hip hop is used to grow. Hip hop is used to stifle. Hip hop is multifaceted, it's versatile. Because at the end of the day, it's the most accurate and realistic manifestation of human creation. That's why we need hip hop.
It's a way to raise our voices against oppression. It values creativity and fairness and equality.
And honestly, the thing that's gonna stick the most with me is the importance of hip hop and how it really is a voice for the voiceless. It's a way for people to express themselves and their creativity, as well as putting forward their truth.
Being like, what's the word, encouraged and pushed forward by their classmates and also by Kashi. And so that was just like picked my interest, and I was always like, I have to take this class before I graduate. I'm actually fortunate, who was like, I think she was 9.0 or 8.0, one of them. She came up to me and she was like, MM, you have to take this class. Like, you have to take this class. This is so you. And I was like, okay.
She taught me that hip hop isn't just MCs. DJs, like, it's also, like, I can dance, and like, it's just expression, and there's so much more to it than just what people automatically assume.
Engaging with people and performing, using certain techniques, pointing out my weaknesses and helping me better them, and things like articulation or just making myself vulnerable. For me, Kashi has also shown me the power of people and community in general, and how one thing like hip hop can bring so many people together. And I think she serves as an inspiration to that, just the power of people.
I believe that hip hop, especially in times like this when we are all quarantined and have to stay isolated, is an expressive and very emotional way of understanding the life and understanding ourselves better. It is a way to grow in a different method, in a method that you don't necessarily experience in your everyday lives, and it can definitely teach you a lot more and push you beyond your barriers. And so I definitely think we need hip-hop for its explosive, emotion-filled environment that it creates.
Don't act like you know. It's kind of took me a while to kind of get used to performing in front of people, because I mean, as a human being, you'd always think you're getting judged, which you are, but it's not always a bad thing, right? So having a great support system pretty much taught me to be fearless. And Kashi was always like, I think she brought this out in everyone. It's like, she wants to bring out the performer in everyone, because everyone has a performer in them, right? And I believe through this class, I've definitely experienced that.
Kashi. If not, well, trash, you know.
3, 2, 1, go.
Classy, boozy, fashion.
Hello and welcome to the Sunny Day News Report. I'm your host, Megan Carroll. Today we're still under strange circumstances and it may feel anything but sunny. We miss our friends, we're stuck in our homes, and we're counting down the days until we can order bottomless mimosas at our favorite restaurant. But
Survive the times.
Throwback for a while. Yeah.